Let's go. Let's join into their match. It looks like we have guards versus guards on Azeri's side there. And see, this is the princess that I was talking about. She sits around the river, and unless you address that princess, she's going to do a ton of damage. But luckily, Azeri went ahead and addressed it. He sent in that Mega Minion to take her out and turn it into a counter push with the giant there. But Chiangzi's got that Inferno Tower. That Inferno Tower does crazy amounts of damage, and especially against these meta decks that we're seeing all the time now, with the giants and especially the bowler or even the giant with the prince, we see it all the time. And that Inferno Tower will pull them into the center there, so that way the Inferno Tower can hit it along with those two other towers as well. Oh snap, we got a rocket coming in doing tons of damage. So now Azeri knows that Chiangzi's got that rocket in there. That's one of those things, you can play the rocket kind of two different ways. You can either hold on to the rocket until the very end, so that way they don't anticipate it. And once you get your opponent's tower low enough, you can just rocket it and do all that damage to take it out. Or you can do what we saw Chiangzi do, where you use it when you need it. So as soon as they drop that elixir pump, you rocket it, so that way they don't get that advantage of the elixir of dropping it on their field there. All right, so here he goes again, same play, dropping that Inferno Tower in the center there. And that Ice Spirit freezes the giant. Giants are not even going to touch the towers. All right, here comes the rocket again. So definitely, Chiangzi is going to rocket that elixir every single time. And you kind of have to rocket it in the very beginning. Because if you don't, then you're allowing that elixir to get its advantage that it's meant for. But if you rocket it in the very beginning, take it out, then they won't be able to get that. All right, so we have guards versus the prince on the left side there. Giant coming in with the guards. And there's another log. Yes, we're seeing these logs today, and I like it. We're finally seeing the log being used because we haven't seen it that much. But Azeri's got those two giants in there. That's going to be detrimental to Chiangzi unless he does something about it. And there he goes. Look at that drop of that Inferno Tower. So it's pulling that giant all the way over to the left side and up towards the river. So he's not even going to be able to touch either one of Chiangzi's towers there. All right, and he's got a princess going in on the left there, Chiangzi does. So he's gonna be, the princess is able to hit that prince at least with one hit and hit the tower at the same time. Inferno Tower is definitely gonna need to do some work here. It's not gonna be able to last to pull it over, but Chiangzi has another one. So now Azeri's gotta be careful because he knows that Chiangzi has that rocket. So he has to be careful not to let his towers get low enough to where that rocket hits it. Look at that log. What a good log that was. That knocked all of them back away from the tower and took out almost all of them with the princess there. Well played. Chiangzi's got this crazy defense. He's just defending the whole game and letting his defense turn into a counter push, which is what you have to do. Oh my gosh, with the lighting. I was wondering what Chiangzi's last card was. So that's another thing. Like I was talking about the rocket, sometimes your best method is to not play the rocket until the very end. And let it kind of sneak up on them. And that's what he kind of did with the lightning there. So Azeri didn't even know he had the lightning until just now when he played it. So now we know what both players' decks are. Azeri kind of has that meta deck that we've been seeing often, where Chiangzi kind of has a unique deck. He's got a variety of spells. The only minions that he has in there, per se, are defensive, smaller minions. So it's just a deck that's slowly but surely chipping away at the towers. Plus, he's got the rocket to do his heavy damage. Or her, I suppose. Log going in. Not much value out of that log, it looks like, other than hitting the tower. I feel like the biggest value of that log comes from knocking the troops back away. And especially if you pair it with something that quickly does damage. For example, an Expo, I feel, paired with the log would be so strong. Because Expo does so much damage per second. And if you can push things constantly back so they can't get to it, it might be a good way to play it. But we haven't seen that so far yet. Alright, so let's see what's going on here. So still going with the same push. Azeri not giving up. He's still pushing with that giant prince behind. We're a minute in overtime. Almost under a minute. So it looks like, as we can see, Chiangzi is just slowly but surely chipping away at that tower. So he knows what his magic number is. He knows how much damage his rocket does, and all he has to do is get that tower low enough to where he can rocket it. So all he's doing right now is he's defending and just slowly chipping away. Like we saw, he's just even throwing the log out there just to do some damage to chip away at it, because he's only got 41 seconds left to do this. And then as soon as he gets low enough, we'll see him drop that rocket. But I'm interested to see if he's going to use the lightning, because lightning's going to do a good amount of damage as well. But maybe he's holding on to it. So here comes the rocket. Not going to be enough, though. But maybe he's going to try to cycle through. Oh, he does the lightning! Now, if he can just do the log, that should be GG right here. There we go! Qiangzi for the win. Well done, Qiangzi. Qiangzi for the win. Well done, well done. Alright, so let's watch Matazi versus Marcus here. Alright, so as we can see, Matazi's got that Lava Hound deck. Marcus, maybe a meta deck. But these Lava Hound decks, especially if you let that Lava Hound go to the point where it gets those lava pups out like that, it can do so much damage. Especially, as you can see, Matazi's deck, he's got it paired with that Inferno Dragon. So Inferno Dragon and Lava Hound obviously are both air troops. So you have to have some kind of air to defend against that. Alright, so that Inferno Tower, it's interesting that he dropped it so close to the tower that Marcus did. But it's working for him. But if he had placed it maybe a little bit more to the center, he could have avoided that poison hitting the tower and the Inferno Tower and the Crown Tower. Look at that miner chipping away at it. That Inferno Dragon, it's a moving Inferno Tower, that's exactly what he is. So we have a lot of air versus air in this battle, but sending in the miner in the back, interesting. And we can see that Marcus tried to anticipate where Matazi was going to drop his miner, but he didn't quite hit it. Alright, so let's see. So he drops the miner. He drops the miner right in the poison, though, but he's still slowly but surely chipping away Marcus's at that tower. And that poison just doing small amounts of damage. Look at that. But even those guards just start slowly chipping away. I mean, he's got it down to 201 HP. Let's see. Is this going to be GG? Yes, it is. For the win with the miner and the poison. Well done by Marcus for the one crown win. That's all you need. One crown to win. All right. So let me enter in their scores here. Marcus for the win. Submit. All right. Nice. So we just got two more battles to watch from round one. All right, let me catch up on your chat a little bit here. Let's see if we can watch another battle. All right, we'll watch Star Wars versus August while I catch up on your chat here. Were you a commentator? Yeah, it really shows. You're a pro play-by-play commentator. Thank you, Isaac. Yes, I'm working on my skills here from that Northern Arena tournament that we did. I've got my commentator voice on. What did people say when the miner was out of the game? It's a minor problem. Jewel Stew, what's going on? Good to see you. Can you make a YouTube video for this tournament? There's so much information. Yes, definitely, Chrome. I definitely can do that. Is the final best out of three? No, it's going to be single elimination for the final round there. Server, what's going on? I'm looking for a lightning deck, no legendary. Can someone... Ah, so Peyton is looking for a lightning deck, if anybody has one. We just saw a lightning deck there, but obviously he had the princess in there. Oh, Rocket Lightning Sightnall. Hey, no shame in it. Whatever deck works for you, gotta go for it. That's what I always say. I know people get frustrated playing the same meta deck over and over again. Or I know people say certain cards are easier to play than others. But, I mean, it's the name of the game. And that's the way that the game is meant to be. It's meant to have the different varieties of decks that you can use. So, you may not like it, but it is what it is and people can play it. Has Skittles been in here lately? Yes, Skittles is lurking right now, I believe, Chaos. But he's definitely been in here. Yeah, Can you ask someone XH, if you were to 1v1 beat BXH in a battle, who would win? Definitely me.
Nope.
Nerds for Revenge coming in with the host, by the way. Thank you so much, Nerds for Revenge. I just saw it. The host work is still not working. My stream labels is just all kinds of sad lately. So, Nerds for Revenge, if you're still in here, thank you. Thank you so, so much for the host. And anybody else that is in here from it, hello to you. Patino77, thank you for the follow. Whoa, nice, Isaac. Holy crap, that's awesome. Where do you buy your clothes? I want to look sexy too. This shirt, I think, is from Target, maybe. Maybe it's from Forever 21. It's just the basic one, though. I watched a stream for you. I'm so done with this game. Evil Eyes, well, thank you. I am flattered. I feel you, though. There's times in this game where I feel like I just want to, like, throw it. Chaos was in here. And he said that he took it off his game. He uninstalled it. Pro1990W, thank you so much. Thank you for the love. I'm going to Target. Be careful, you go in Target, you're gonna walk out with like a new bag, you're gonna walk out with like a new toothpaste, maybe some new pillows, who knows what. You walk in Target for one thing, you walk out with like a cart full, and you're like, shit, what just happened? Sorry, I never cuss on stream. Yet I did, I'm sorry. Hi, 83, hello there, hello, hello. Alright, everybody. So, August coming in with a one, the win there. Alright, so now we have August versus Cheongzi. Alright, so next we have to watch Ash versus Giselle. Alright, so now we've got, let's see, Cheongzi versus August. You guys can go ahead. Cheongzi versus August. Alright, so Ash versus Giselle, did they go? They did. Alright, so let's watch Ash versus Giselle. Alright, so I already see a goblin barrel, so I already know. First time I heard you cuss. I know, I never cuss. I don't know why I just did. I did. I said the S word. And it felt like so not like me. And I'm like, huh? Sorry, everybody. Alright, so we got a Lava Hound deck. It looks like. Versus maybe like a quick cycle deck, because we see the goblin barrel in there. Usually when I see goblin barrel, that tells me quick cycle, especially when I see it paired with a miner. All right, so there goes the goblin barrel, and with the zap taking it out, Ash is not playing any games. Interesting, he places the tombstone and the elixir so close together there, but maybe that's beneficial knowing that Giselle has that miner. Lava Hound making a slow trip from Ash's side there. Let's see. Look at that Inferno Tower placement. So it's going to pull the Lava Hound right in there. Minion Horde going in for the kill, killing the Lava Pups. Minion Horde against the Lava Hound is so strong. It really is. And it's nice, too, because unless you have arrows in your deck, if the Minion Horde is on your opponent's side, they're defending using it, you can't really take them out unless you have the arrows, because the zap will just kind of take them down to half health, and that'll still allow them to take out the Lava Hound, take out the Lava Pups like we just saw. So the good thing is that there's a lot of great defenses against it, like Princess. She does the air damage, she'll take out those Lava Pups, but she's just slower to do it. Alright, so there we go. So Ash for the win. That was quick. That's what we get for doing it in double time. Alright, so now we've got Ash versus Marcus and Cheongzi versus August for our semifinals here. And we've got Marcus versus Ash. Alright, so let's watch August versus Cheongzi's battle here. They are midway through this battle. All right, so we see August has got a Lava Hound deck versus Chiangzi. So this is that deck that we saw. That it's a chip away deck that's got the lightning and it's got the rocket in there. So his goal of this game is to just slowly but surely keep chipping away until he gets August Tower low enough to where he can rocket it. But we've also seen him, anytime he sees an Elixir Collector, then he rockets it. All right, so here he goes in, just hitting nothing but the tower with that rocket. So full value going into August's tower there. So August is taking this opportunity. He knows that Chiangzi has just spent 6 elixir, so he's going to take this advantage, spend the 7 elixir, and drop the Lava Hound. Interesting deck. I mean, with the Tombstone against it, it's going to be good against... Let's see. Well, it'll be good if it's paired time-wise well with the Lava Hounds as a distraction, but unfortunately with the Inferno Tower, it'll target and quickly take out the skeletons that come out and then retarget onto Lava Hound. So it looks like this time around, Chiangzi is just going to be cycling through to his rocket and rocket it every time to try to chip away and let that be his direct damage on the August Tower there. Oh snap, August going in, oh my gosh! Whoa, August has a mirror in his deck. That's another one I feel like I don't see that often. Especially now mirror has recently got its buff. So now, whatever you deploy and you mirror it, it does it the level above. Oh. Yes, yes, Chiangzi, even with the rocket, not going to get much love for this. It's, that tower is just not low enough on August's side there for him to be able to rocket it. So there it is, August for the win. Good job, August. All right, so August is going to our finals here. Alright, so August can hang out, and now we're gonna figure out if it's Marcus or it's Ash. Alright, so let's watch the remainder of Marcus versus Ash's battle here. So we've seen a lot of Lava Hounds tonight. So that Lava Hound on the left there just slowly but surely making its trip up there. And that Musketeer is definitely gonna damage it, but I love Ash's response to it. He drops that Miner, but Marcus was anticipating it. He dropped that Prince right behind. But still, that Miner able to take out the Musketeer, helping do damage. But holy crap, look at that zap by Marcus. That was a lot of value out of that zap because it took out all of those Lava Pups. And I feel like that's one with the zap like that, you have to time it right to where all the Lava Pups are close enough where you can zap all of them. Because zap doesn't quite have the radius as arrows do, for example. You arrow it, you know you're going to be able to hit all of them. Alright, so here we go. That classic push. We've got the giant with the prince behind. I love that ice spirit. Such good value because it only costs you 1 elixir. Oh, double Lava Hounds from Ash going in there. They're slow moving. Their damage per second is slow, but if they can get all the way down there with those Lava Pups, that's where your damage is. If they can last all the way until he pops or dies, whatever you want to call it, and the Lava Pups come out. With the zap in, though Marcus defending well, only 10 seconds to go. It looks like it's going to be GG for Ash there. Though it's chipping away, that Miner's chipping away, the poison's chipping away, but it's not quite enough there. If he had the rocket, he'd be able to rocket that tower, but he doesn't. So nice. Marcus for the win. Congrats, Marcus. All I do is battle. All right, so our final battle here. So this is going to be single elimination. It's going to be August versus Marcus. Ready, August and Marcus? All I do is win, win, win. Alright guys, so here's our final match. Whoever wins this battle is going to walk away today with a gift card, their choice of iTunes or Google Play. Dun, dun. Thank you. Alright, so here we go, guys. And as you can see, here's the gift cards here. So it'll be their choice of whichever one they would like to do. Ogano1212, thank you very much. I appreciate that. Frenaxens, hello there. Alright, guys, let's watch. Alright, already going in with that Miner. And that Miner paired with poison. So I wonder as well if Marcus was anticipating that Miner going into the center there. But August kind of faked him out and did it on the tower instead of doing directly on the elixir, which is what we typically expect to see. Hog Rider going in by himself. Oh, and get hit by the Inferno Tower. Oh, and the lightning as well. Lightning from Marcus there. So lightning now, I guess, does the same effect that Zap does. It stuns whatever it hits. And buildings, for example, like the Inferno Tower or something that shoots, like Sparky, it resets them. So there the princess goes. So unless they handle her, do something, you cannot leave her. She will just slowly but surely chip away at your tower there. Whoa, look at those skeletons dragging that Inferno, or that Mega Minion all the way across there. Alright, so we got Miner coming in. Marcus tried to anticipate exactly where that Miner was going to go. He didn't quite hit it on the mark, but still, the Mega Minion's flying, so he just flies right over there to take out that Miner. And by his lonesome self, crossing the river. Alright, so we got Princess in the middle. Guards coming down the right side there. Look at that. Hog Rider paired with those skeletons, which is great. Because he was anticipating August to probably place the Inferno Tower in the center. So, by doing that, and having the hog on the inside of the three skeletons, ideally, the Inferno Tower should target onto each of those skeletons and let the hog run straight to the tower. But, August, he countered that, and he placed the Inferno Tower just on the left, right in front of the Hog Rider, which was well played by August, I have to say. Alright, Princess shooting, Miner left alone for just a moment there. And then Marcus dropping in the Mega Minion. There goes Hog Rider on the opposite side now. Going in lots of health. Ooh, Inferno Tower right on him though. I wonder if that was wise for August to do. It's interesting to see the Inferno Tower being placed somewhere other than the center. Because in the center of the field, it's obviously most versatile. So that way, no matter what's coming down the river, it can hit it. Oh, we got a donate. Hi, Subway. Thank you.
You're awesome.
Woo! iSubway, thank you so much for the donate. We are watching the final battle here. Travis, welcome back, by the way. Hog Rider going in. So Marcus is just one at a time sending in that Hog Rider. But here it goes. Marcus has that Inferno Tower defending. And there it goes. A Miner for the win by Marcus.